Ciao a tutti, day 29 of our wine quarantine, and today we're going to Barbarica Silva. Barbarica Silva, it's a hill that for the longest time was under the control of the Ligurian Celts. The Romans crossed the Tanaro River several times, and they fought until they finally defeated the barbarians. From that moment on, the vine will substitute the large oaks that are so sacred to the Celts. So Rome is everywhere today in the territory we know as Barbaresco. It's in Neve, as the town originated from the wealthy aristocratic Roman family known as Gens Nevia. It's in Treso, from the Latin tres, as the third outpost along the important road that connected Barbarica Silva to Alba Pompeia, but it's also in San Rocco Senodelvio, as the town was the birthplace of the Roman emperor Publio Elvio Pertinace. But also the Celts left something very important, a very important word in the history of Barbaresco, known as brig, which is the equivalent of collina, which is the equivalent of brick. So now, Nebbiolo-based wines were produced here since at least the 18th century, and figured that prior to the 1890s, grapes from the Barbaresco areas were actually used for the production of Barolo. At that time, there was no clear definitions of territory-specific wines producing one area versus the other. Although a very important historical figure, the most important or first in the history of Barbaresco, is Domizio Cavazza, which in 1894 acquires il Castello di Barbaresco and founded the first cantina sociale or cooperative cellar of Barbaresco. From this moment, the wine Barbaresco is born. Unfortunately, Domizio Cavazza dies prematurely and cantina sociale goes out of business, later to be reborn as produttori del Barbaresco. In the late 1950s and early 1960s, some very important historical producers of Barbaresco come onto the stage, such as Angelo Gaia and Bruno Giacosa. They really show the world-class wines that can come out of Barbaresco. So now, Barbaresco as a territory is located on the right bank of the Tanaro River, right? It's a small territory. We are in the north east of the town of Alba, and it's composed of three villages, Barbaresco being the main one, Treso, Neve, and a small piece also San Rocco Senodelvio. Altogether, the territory is small, I figure that it's about a third of the territory of Barolo, right? It's, as we just mentioned, it's closer to the Tanaro River than Barolo, which means conditions are going to be warmer and they're going to be milder, although we're still within a continental environment, but that gives a more consistent ripening of the grapes, which is critical to Nebbiolo and the quality of Nebbiolo wines producing in this area, right? So now, as far as elevations, also Barbaresco, generally speaking, it's a little lesser or a little lower than Barolo, most of the vineyards being located between 450 and about 1100 feet of elevations. Now, if we have to start talking about soils in Barbaresco, we kind of draw a line where in one part there are the so-called Sant'Agata Marls, or Marne di Sant'Agata, which are soils of Tertonian geological origin. And these we find them mostly in the town of Barbaresco and partly in Neve. These are calcareous marls with elements of sand, same exact type of soils you find in western Barolo, and the wines typically from this area tend to be elegant and refined. Versus on the other side, we find the Formazione di Lequio, Lequio formations, which are partially Tortonian, partially Serravallian origin, and we find them in Treso, San Rocco Senodelvio, and part of Neve. And these are territories that are composed of grey marls alternating with layers of sand, and soil and wines coming out of these territories tend to be more structured, bolder, and more age-worthy as a general idea. Now, most of the vineyards found within the territory of Barbaresco are actually in the town of Barbaresco. That accounts for the majority of production. Versus in Neve, we find less Nebbiolo, but more Dolcetto, Barbera, and Moscato Bianco. And lastly, in Treso, also there is lesser Nebbiolo, but more Dolcetto produced. It's all for today. Tomorrow for part number two and a nice tasting. In alto i cuori. Ciao!